So we're back, and we're going to talk primarily about being a woman at Berkeley. But I wanted to start with your telling me what was how you were invited to come back as a tenured professor. Yes.
I had returned to Toronto, and to my surprise, got a letter from the department inviting me to, wanting to know whether I was interested in being considered for an appointment. And then ultimately they decided to make that appointment. Now, that you talked about my being a woman at Berkeley, that my question about what to do, questions I asked myself, certainly had a lot to do with that, because my husband was at Toronto with a wonderful position and not as movable as some men might be with his list of publications and his mathematical creativity because of the problem that he'd had with HUAC and this past of being backlisted. In other words, he couldn't say, just say, oh yes, we'll go. Right. We were there in Toronto, we had a home, we had three children at school. And at that point, we're now in I guess I must have gotten the invitation in 1970-71 because I moved down in December of 71. At that point, it was less common for a wife to make the move and the husband to somehow negotiate or work out or improvise or follow or commute. It is more common now. It's still not always easy, but it's more common. And we thought about it. My memory of how wonderfully open and creative the months had been in 68 when I was here was very strong. My work was going in new directions, which I anticipated would be appreciated here. It would be very stimulating. And even though I had had a regular job, a good job with interesting students and colleagues at Toronto, it seemed wonderful. So we sat down and talked about it. And I remember that night so well. We had fire was going in the fireplace in our cold Toronto. And we said, let's try it. We said, let's try it for 5 years. The first year I can take a leave, and then you'll have a leave, and then maybe I can commute some, and we'll see how it goes, and we'll try it. And I like that formulation, and I've used it with some of my younger friends when they've had just choices of this kind. We'll try it, see if it works. If it doesn't work, you won't do it.
So had Chandler come out in 68?
Yes, he had come out after he'd finished teaching, and the term ends very early at Toronto, so he'd already come out by April with our other two children, because I was just out with our son. And this time, Aaron, our boy, our son, our oldest, was through high school and thinking about college, and all three children loved Berkeley. And Hannah just had to finish 1 year. She spent some time in France at a high school in France, and it was only Simone that really had a Berkeley high school time. She was really our Berkeley daughter, and we didn't. I think I'm very glad we made the decision that we did. I think we didn't anticipate some of the problems that we had, which we got through. The short range problems were that you think, oh, everything will be fine. Natalie will go out and we'll commute and it'll work out. But, you know, it was an unusual thing to do. And although it seemed perfectly rational and effective, you do have feelings underneath that are associated with more traditional ways of looking at male-female relations and so on. And those, we were the kind of family with our idealism and our egalitarian beliefs that wouldn't want those beliefs to be right out in the open.